Hey, what's going on YouTube? Krosama here, and today we're going to take a look at the Figurize Labo Hatsune Miku. Now, this is from the Project Diva line, or if you want to say the Vocaloid, whatever your introduction was. My introduction was Project Diva. I played the game on PSP, Vita, and PS3. Haven't touched the PS4 version yet, but one of my favorite music games, you know, coming off of Pump It Up, DDR, Taiko Drum Master. So playing, music games is kind of my main genre outside of like maybe JRPGs. But absolutely love the design of Miku. It's really nice. It's, like a Sailor Moon kind of character. I really enjoy it. And this figure is super beautiful and like just high gloss. It looks perfect. And the injection molding that they do on this it's remarkable, honestly. So let's take a look at the box. Now, I'd like to thank NewTypeHQ.com for sponsoring this video. This figure is not currently available, but if you go and check out the link in the description below, you can go ahead and save that, and then whenever it does become live, you can go ahead and buy it and use that promo code Krosama, so that way you can get 10% off. Now, the front cover art is actually pretty normal. Nothing too spectacular here. All you're gonna have is the figure, statue, whatever you wanna call it, right there on the front, and then it has layered injection, and then just the Figurize Labo, and then the Hatsune Miku right there on the side. Now, in terms of pricing, I really don't know what the default pricing is. I think the previous ones, all the other Labos, they came in roughly around like $70, $75. This I picked up for $60, so I don't know if that's going to be the average, but just keep on checking around, maybe even check NewTypeHQ to see if they're going to have it. And if you look on the side of the box, you're just going to get another shot of her, and if you keep going all the way down here, you're going to get some information on her, and even going further down, you're going to get some Labo information that you can go ahead and pause and go ahead and read. And some information on how they do all that layered injection, and just more of that description right here below. Now, I'm not going to show every single runner, but I'll show you the ones that are more notable. So for this one, this is just the eyes, but you can see that they actually, have the different injection molding to create one part. Bandai has done this in the past before, but I think it was with the original high-grade F91, if I'm not mistaken. But yeah, this is, it's still really cool, and the eyes look really nice, pretty glossy. So pretty excited to go ahead and put this together and see exactly how it looks all whole. And next we have is going to be the face. So yeah, pretty much the same concept. You're gonna have all those different molding injections right inside there. So you got the blue and you're gonna have the black and so on and so forth. Now the orange, I think, is supposed to kind of, bring out the flesh tone with the face. That's pretty much the predominant reason that they have that. Not really too sure. I'm gonna have to take a look at it up close. But yeah, for the most part, it looks pretty good. Now for the twin tails, you are gonna have different injections. So you have like this very light sky blue, and then you're gonna have this, I would say a little bit darker tone blue, but it's still like a light blue. And yeah, they're just gonna inject it in different, segments of the hair, so that way it looks really good. It has like a lighter tone, but you can still see the darkness in it, so it gets lighter as you go further down. But yeah, it looks, it looks pretty good. Not really too noticeable from a distance, but definitely when you get up close, you will see the, lighter tone at the bottom. Now you also get a set of dry transfers as well as some stickers. So I don't know how many of these are going to be necessary to transfer over, but I'm probably going to try and use as many as possible. Now we're going to take a closer look at the completed figure. The face, like you've seen in the actual unboxing portion of this video, it's actually going to have, like, not necessarily the layered injection, but it is going to have the parts right behind one another, and the orange that is in front, or sorry, the orange that is in the back of the flesh tone part is just not really that vibrant in my opinion. Like, it doesn't really make too much of a difference. I guess it's probably making a difference if you go like really up close and look at it, but as of right now, I'm not seeing it. But the eyes, that's going to have like the same kind of concept, and the eyes, they are going to look really beautiful. And just looking at the eyes, it's pretty mesmerizing. I really love how they just like made so much detail pop out in just such a small little part. Now for the body and the arms, you can see like all that like color detail. Those are all going to be dry transfers, except for small, like some small little things are going to be dots that are stickers. So you see that little dot right up there, that is actually a sticker. To be honest, the stickers don't look that great. I'm not a big fan of them, but hey, they exist. I'm just not a fan of the stickers on this kit. Even the dry transfers, I think are okay. But man, I don't know. Maybe I'm a little bit annoyed that this thing even has those kind of items. Like, granted, I'm not asking for all the small details to be molded because I know that's going to be really hard. This is a model kit after all. And maybe I should use model kit very loosely. There's a lot of things going on with this. But, you know, overall, I do like it. I think even without the stickers and the decals, this thing can still look amazing on your shelf. And since I'm a, you know, huge Hatsune Miku fan, this is going to go good with the rest of my figures as well as statues. And just looking at the skirt, so looks really good. You're gonna have like parts on top of parts on top of parts. So the translucent blue, and then you're gonna have like the very vibrant blue, and then the glossy black on top of each other. That's all looking fantastic. Then the stickers are gonna be where like, I guess like, I don't know what that is, like a belt or it's like straps. Yeah, I think it's like straps. But yeah, that's gonna be stickers. Looks pretty good though. Now for the legs and stand, the stockings are going to be super glossy, and the stand is going to be in that clear blue that just looks really good. I absolutely love the stand. It's super simplistic, but I just love the kind of grid look. It looks really awesome, and the fact that she has like her one leg kind of chilling on the back, that looks fantastic, and then the hyper gloss on the stockings, that just, I don't know man, it looks really great, and honestly, I love it. I don't really have any kind of issues with it. It's a pretty awesome looking figure. And here she is all completed. Honestly, super elegant. I love the way she looks, the hair strands with the layered injection in the hair. It looks great. Some of the pros I would have is obviously just going to be a looks, aesthetics, overall. The pose is fantastic. The coating, the glossy coat that's on it, the engineering that went into this, it's great. I really do love it. Now, going into the cons, it's really going to be the stickers and dry transfer decals. You know, I don't really have as much of a problem with the dry transfer as I do the stickers, but overall, I do wish it was water slides. I think that would have looked so much better. Also, I do have a problem with the price point. I don't know how much the cost is for engineering something like this, but I do feel that about 6,000, 6,500 yen is a pretty high price point, if I do say so. That's even more than a master grade, and some of these master grades have just a lot going for them, whereas this is a static statue. It's not posable. It has like really good engineering with the layered injection for the hair, but I mean, what else are you really getting with this? Obviously the coating is great, the colors are very vibrant, I love the translucent colors. But yeah, I don't know if it's truly worth that price point, but me, I am a huge Hatsune Miku fan, so I think it's worth it for me. But if you are not a big fan of maybe, Hatsune Miku, or perhaps just anime or Vocaloid in general, this may not be the right figure for you just because of that price point. You could easily get a Banpresto one for significantly cheaper. I bought like a lot of cheaper statues for probably around like 1500 yen. Maybe go that route, go on eBay, go on Amazon. But yeah, this is something that's like a high-end collectible, not necessarily just a run-of-the-mill, put it on your shelf and hey, cool. This is something you're really going to want to showcase a little bit in the center of your collection. Now that's pretty much it for me. I don't have a whole lot to say about this statue. There's really not much going on. I mean, I can definitely talk a little bit more about the colors and details, but that's just kind of dragging this video on longer than what it needs to be. So I'm going to go ahead and get going. And if you do want to pick this up, hey, remember to go to newtypehq.com. Use that promo code Krosama for that 10% off just to save you at least a few bucks. But if you really do want this, guys, I really recommend it. Like I said, if you're just not a fan, maybe you're gonna have to pass on it. Other than that, I'll be seeing you guys later. Bye bye. And I'd like to give a quick shout out to all my members of the channel. Honestly, guys, without your help, things would be so much harder to actually produce content on this channel. So thank you so much for supporting me, and I'm just extremely grateful. But thank you very much.